All right, if we look inside, you can see I'm painting my son's Volkswagen. It's going to be like a baby blue and cream white. So I'm staying pretty busy over here. We got one coat of paint on this. We got to put three more coats of paint, three coats of clear. But it's looking really, really nice. And while I'm doing that, Weekly Loser is supposed to be block sanding the 66 Chevelle. Let's go see what he's found and what the fuck's going on with it. What's up?
Well, we're finding a little more work than we had anticipated. A little more damage.
Find a lot of imperfections in it?
Yeah.
Where at?
I found one there. One right there.
So, using the big straight block, the hard block, is getting us down to the nitty-gritty where there's actually more damage on this than we suspected.
That's right.
Alright, so you did the back here. You did the back, and I see a lot of fucking tape going on, bud. What's up? I see a lot of tape.
High spots, a few of them, most of them are low. And we got Bondo.
Alright, that's
a whole bunch of stuff going on.
Yeah, that's pretty common right there in that area because they didn't replace that. You know, I'm trying to be nice to you. I'm trying to be nice. Because I got a lot of shit going on my side of the shop.
Well, things are going just fine over on this side of the shop.
Now, what about our door? If I remember right, I think Big Paw Don. Big Paw 64 guy said that the door skins were replaced as well. Have you found any damage on those?
Got a little bit of a dent right here. A little bit of one right here. Our corners tucked in a little bit there.
Okay, is that a Bondo effect or is that the skin effect?
I think it's skin. I didn't find any Bondo down here.
So then we get up on the roof and what's going on with that?
Well, we hit the roof, we started up here and we ran right into Bondo. Came across here, found a pretty good dent right here.
Uh-huh.
And I kept going across here, it feels pretty good up in here.
It looks like you're gonna have to double block that roof. It's pretty rough looking.
Yeah.
Make sure it's done right.
Looks like some hail damage here.
Yeah, it sure does, doesn't it? That's a good sign. If you look real close, you can see all the little spots of Bondo that were, that might have been some minor hail damage. This is an old car, Weekly. You didn't sand over here yet. What's up with this?
No, I haven't sanded over there yet.
Okay,
I got it from here.
Don't forget.
Come around.
Alright. I'm gonna get this fucker painted within the next week or two, bud. Let's go. We're playing around.
This is pretty much common for a car like this that somebody's already done the bodywork to. It's pretty common to find imperfections and small minor dents in the car. That's why we got Weekly Loser here block sanding it vigorously with a dry block with the guide coat on it. Now you understand what the fuck a guide coat is for. Without the guide coat, we couldn't have found those dents because it would have been all camouflaged in the primer itself. We'll let Weekly Loser finish the whole car out. We'll be back. I'm sure he's not going to finish today because this type of job takes at least 3 to 4 days to even do, just to find the damage that's still left on it. All right, Weekly Loser finally got off his ass and actually did something today. And what he did is he got our 1969 Chevelle ready for bodywork. Let's look at it and see what he found after he block sanded it down using a guide coat and a long block. If you look at the car, you can see everywhere that he put a piece of tape, there's a dent. There's a small dent or a large dent, but wherever you see the tape, there's a dent. I can see that at one time this might have had a vinyl top. This might have been a vinyl top car the way that it's looking here with the minor surface rust that's going on, but it's still in good shape. The primer that they put on this car was just a skim coat of primer just to seal it off, but you can see that Weekly Loser actually did something good, took his time and blocked it down thoroughly to get it ready for body work. Did you work hard today, bud?
Not really.
You didn't work hard today? What kind of work did you do then?
Clown shit.
Oh, really? So sanding that car was a clown act?
I didn't sand any car today.
Yeah, you did.
No, I did.
Oh, did you finish that yesterday?
Yeah.
You finished it yesterday?
Yeah.
So it was yesterday when you finished it. So you're hiding shit on me.
Well, you need to pay attention. What's going on around here? Keep track of your own.
Get the fuck out of here. See you later.
Roger, Doctor.
I'll see you in the morning, bright and early. We got a lot of shit to do.
Well, whenever the fuck he got it done, he got it done. And it's a done deal. And the next thing we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and start our body work on it. Get it done so we can get it in primer. And get it done so we can get it painted. And get her done and get it the fuck out of here. What else can I say? We'll be back as we do the body work on the 69 Chevelle.
Cocksucker, it's a son of a bitch, motherfucking cocksucker's what it is, because it's a son of a bitch, it's like a fucking bastard.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about that right there. Hell yeah, I'm talking about that.
You know, now that we got the car stripped down and now that it's all been dry block sanded out, this, that, and the other, we've really got to start getting some progress going on this old car, because now is when we really got to start getting serious. You know, it's fun clowning around and having a good time and, you know, being the clown factory that the situation has led us to be. But now it's time that we got to get the bodywork done on this, and we got to get it done right. So what we're going to do is we're going to basically start on the back end just like we did from the beginning. We start everything from the back. We're going to move our way forward. And we're going to try to get all this done today. This is a big job, due to the fact that these corners of these quarter panels here, somebody really fucked this up right here. And when I say fucked it up, what they did is they took the factory original seam that was supposed to be there and they went ahead and welded that up. Now, I'm thinking that they got in a hurry, and this was probably toward the end of the whole job, but they got in a hurry and decided, fuck it, I'll just weld that up and then I'll Bondo over that and be done with it. And it's also the same on the other side as well. Now, another thing we got here, there was some rust down in this corner, I see. And if we look right here, you can see where the guy welded it up. So we'll grind that down and make sure that that's all welded up airtight, and also fix all this mess right here. So we're gonna go ahead and leave the glass in here. And while we're working, we wanna cover that glass, because we do not want the glass to be ruined, especially on this car here. You gotta cover the glass with this type of a blanket. This is called a welding blanket. And what that does, that keeps all the grind sparks and welding sparks and everything else kind of sparks that might get in the way off of the glass. So it's real important to do this, see? Just like that. Before we start any type of welding, what we want to do, we want to go ahead and clean this out. So I'm going to take my cutting wheel, and I'm going to go ahead and grind that down using my cutting wheel, and being very careful not to hit the deck lid at the same time. And then on the other hand, sometimes it'll take an extra type of tool, different tools, to clean it up properly and get it where you want it. And And it's very important remembering that there's glass in here, so you don't want to fucking hit it with your tool. That looked like that cleaned up very, very nicely. The guy that did this bodywork in this area actually did a pretty good job. The only thing he fucked up on is welding this up right here. So we're gonna go ahead and finish it out and weld it up across that seam just like he has it. And then we'll see what happens from there. Now we'll go ahead and repeat our process. And the reason I'm going back to my cutting wheel is because in the center of this there's a high spot. I want to get rid of that high spot. Now if you look at that, you can see that it's all been welded up solid and it looks like it was made that way from the factory. But we're not done there. We're not done yet. What I'm going to do now is I'm also going to take my cutting wheel. Once that's like that, get that a little bit more. I need my body hammer. I need my body hammer to finish this out. Like I said, it's a little bit high in this area right here, and that's mainly caused probably from fitting the panel together, and also the welding in this area has caused that to raise. So what I'm gonna do, so I'm gonna take my body hammer and I'm gonna start dulling it down with my hammer. Notice how I'm using my hammer. I got one finger, I'm holding it in the middle, and I got a finger to keep it so it doesn't pop back. Do you see what I'm saying? I'm doing nice, firm little taps on it. One more thing, it's pretty irrelevant that we're gonna have to put body filler in here. So it really doesn't matter if you got any more lower low spots than you already do. Because once we get this done, it will all look brand new. And while I'm hammering this area, I'm also visually looking at it. I'm visually looking at it, looking for high spots, using the light of the sun rays there coming in and showing me if there's any high spots or low spots. And I would say that that is ready for filler. We're not done here yet. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. Because I told you I was going to fill that in and then just make it smooth, but I don't like to do that because that looks jerry-rigged and it also looks half-assed, because anybody that knows these cars is going to know that that body line is right there that travels straight down the trunk line as well. And what we're going to do, we're going to take our grinder and we are going to grind that out. We're going to grind it out deep enough to where once we put our Bondo in there, we'll be able to go ahead and make a seam that travels the same distance and structure as our trunk line does, and it'll be back to factory looking original authenticity, you might say. Look at that right there. We can see, even though we welded that up solid, we still have a valley that we can work with once we apply our Bondo and our filler. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and weld this hole up. He doesn't want that hole there anymore. And then when we come back, we're going to start our body work on the back end of the car.